Bought devices by Global Star uses second-generation satellite technology that allows customers to track themselves and their assets, send messages, and contact search and rescue. Spot Trace is the theft alarm tracker that monitors the movement and location. Spot Gen 3 lets off-the-grid adventurers send messages, track movement, and call for help. Spot by Global Star, satellite technology. Support for WYES is made possible by Mary Lou Kristovich in memory of her husband, William Kristovich.
Peggy Scott Laborde, and welcome to Steppin Out, spotlighting the New Orleans area's arts and entertainment scene. Seated at our table tonight, actor, singer, and performer Jeff Roberson, who portrays Varla Jean Merman and does so much more. And he's here to discuss his latest, which is called Still Poinsettias at Rivertown through December 22nd. So we're thrilled with that. Poppy Tooker, host of the WWNO radio program, Louisiana Eats. Good to see you, Miss Poppy, as always. He's back. If he's not in New Orleans, he's in Venice. Gypsy jazz guitarist and visual artist, Tony Green. Antonio Verde. Yes, who will be performing for us a little later this evening. And Steppin' Out theater critic, he's back. Alan Smason, editor of the Crescent City Jewish News, and back from Israel.
Yes, absolutely.
Welcome. I hope you had a great trip. First up, though, Miss Poppy.
Some kind of big news for Louisiana Eats. We've been nominated for a Taste Award, which is a national food media
Congratulations.
Award. And we're nominated in three categories, Best Food Program, Best Food Broadcast, and Best Food Podcast. Now, this is a People's Choice Award, which means that everybody's got to vote. Please, please, either go to poppytooker.com or the Tastemakers Award. Mm-hmm. It takes 5 minutes. Just vote, vote, vote the three categories, and maybe I'll make a showing. So thanks.
Congrats. That's really good
really
news.
Really exciting. Yes. February, they give out the award. And then the nicest thing that I just heard about, the Women's Guild of the Jackson Avenue German Evangelical Congregation. Now, they've been there since 1845. It's a very historical little old church. And they do a Christmas bazaar every year. And they'll have these every Sunday until Christmas time. But this time, from noon until 4 p.m., coming up on the 11th, this Sunday, they're doing German pastries and German sweets. For the very first time, they're opening up a German dessert cafe for the afternoon. And it's going to coincide with the Preservation Resource Center tour that's going to take place in the Garden District. And proceeds from this inaugural event will benefit the Fairhaven Children's Home in Covington, which is a wonderful place where generations of foster children have been given a permanent home with two loving parents. And the church's gift will make sure that everyone has a Merry Christmas there.
Double.
Then talk about a Merry Christmas and holiday fun. Let's take a picture at Tableau. They have this amazing, huge mistletoe that was actually made by local artist Robin Durand. And all you have to do is take a picture kissing under the mistletoe. And
by next to the petite.
Now, you see these two. This is really great. That's Jordy Brower, Lauren Brennan Brower's son, and his wife, Sally. So you do hashtag Tableau Mistletoe, either on Facebook or Instagram, and you'll enter a contest for a dinner for two. Santa's also visiting for brunch and photos on December 18th, and Tableau's $48 four-course Réveillon dinner served through the 23rd.
That's a deal.
Then a little scoop about something coming in the new year. Louisiana Eats and French Market Coffee are coming together to create a dinner series to benefit the Southern Food and Beverage Museum. The first one up is going to be on Thursday, January the 12th. Chef Slade Rushing of Brennan's Restaurant is going to do a fantastic meal. Then in March the 23rd, also a Thursday, Chris Montero at the Napoleon House is going to be doing a dinner. Both dinners are $95 inclusive. They're held in the Rouse's Culinary Innovation Center at the Southern Food and Beverage
Museum. So they are there.
They are there at the museum. Okay. And the Brennan's menu, egg yolk carpaccio with sauteed shrimp, andouille vinaigrette, French Market Coffee, toffee crusted pork loin with bacon glazed turnips. I want some of those now. And of course, he's going to serve bananas Foster for dessert. So to buy tickets, which would make a really great Christmas gift, go to poppytucker.com, and all the proceeds will be benefiting the Southern Food and Beverage Museum, our Louisiana Eats home.
All right. Thank you so much. And it's so great to have Jeff and you and your partner in crime,
Ricky Graham.
I have such great admiration for, because in addition to acting, that's only one thing. It's writing and producing and costuming and all that great stuff. But you lead another life as Varla Jean Merman.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
And
I'm
you're
a professional
also
woman.
And I didn't realize that you had Louisiana roots. I remember, I know you spent part of the time in Provincetown.
Provincetown, I go every summer because it's a great place to work and make some good money, but I'm there June, July, and August. But I was born in Houston, and I grew up in Lake Charles, Monroe, Natchitoches. Wow. Went to Louisiana School in Natchitoches, and then I ended up at LSU. And then I moved to New York in like about 93. For about 6 years.
So tell us about the name Varla Jean Merman for the uninitiated.
Well, Varla Jean Merman, at the time I wrote it, it was really supposed to be the illegitimate daughter of Ethel Merman and Ernest Borgnine. They were married for 38 days. Now nobody knows who they are anymore. So, you know, but Ethel Merman's autobiography, she has a chapter that says, "My marriage to Ernest Borgnine," and you turn the page and it's blank. So I just thought if she had a baby, she would have wanted to, you know, not have it as a reminder of Mr. Borgnine.
So steel magnolias, steel
poinsettias. So Ricky and I were thinking of doing a Christmas play, and you know, we wanted to do a spoof of something, and so, you know, it always starts with the title, where we come from. So I thought of poinsettias, and then somehow steel came together, and so now it is, you know, it's a satire, really, of
there's
steel.
There's Ricky at the bottom. He's
actually Sean Patterson.
Oh, that's Sean Patterson.
Yeah.
Okay.
And that's, yeah, Brooklyn Schaefer.
I'm
Marlene Cratchit on the right with the bow in my hair.
With
blue bow.
Beautiful.
Gray.
Do you do your own makeup?
I do, yeah. You just learn how to do it. But it's great because Mrs. Claus, Michael Sullivan and Sean Patterson,
Ricky.
Brooklyn Schaefer. That's me.
Wow. Can you do a little voice, a little bit of a voice for us?
Or? Oh, Peggy, what do you mean? Oh, it's a little early.
And in this one, I have more of a, I sort of sound like Blanche from Golden Girls. But Mrs. Claus has a hair salon, and if you've ever seen Steel Magnolias, that's kind of the Dolly Parton part. I have the Sally Fields role where, you know, and I have the child who's sick, who's Julie Roberts, but I'm Marlene Cratchit and Tiny Tim. You know, drink your eggnog, Tiny, you know. And then Ricky plays Frosty the Snowman's wife, and then Michael Sullivan plays the misfit dentist elf, and Sean Patterson plays Wheezy Grincho, which is the Shirley MacLaine part, but, you know, the grouch.
Right.
And so, you know, she ends up trying to steal Christmas, and
it's
really nice.
No, I understand you've also, here are the details, of course, but you added some performances,
We have sold out so many shows that we're adding them like crazy. If you want a ticket, just go to the website. We're running to the 22nd now, so we're running right up to Christmas, and we're at as many shows as you guys need, so go get your tickets.
A quick question, you know, what is a writing session? What does that consist of?
Ricky and I would just laugh. Yeah, I'd whine, and a lot of times we'll go to Starbucks and just work for like 3 or 4 hours, just sit there and just laugh and just, you know, think of ideas. And the great part about, you know, Steel Magnolias is you take sort of the plot lines, and we've totally changed it, but then you kind of see the similarities and where you can put, like, you know, the Grinch being the Shirley MacLaine, the Grouch was just so easy to do, and then, you know, the Marlene Cratchit, and just taking all these different characters. And we have Southern accents because we're at the South Pole.
Okay.
Yeah, so it's good. And there's some local references, but it's really, it's just, you know, it's a nice little hilarious show. Yeah. Everybody is so great. I've worked with Sean Patterson, who's just amazing.
There's a comfort level there.
Oh, and Michael Sullivan in Brooklyn, all these people. And Jefferson Turner has done all the arrangements, and we take classic Christmas
songs. So it's music.
It's a musical.
It's a musical.
It's a musical.
Poinsettias. People in New Orleans, I think sometimes I hear poinsettias.
Yeah, poinsettias.
Poinsettias. Anyway, it's great to have you.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
And New Orleans Magazine's quiz queen, Julia Street, has a question for us. Last time, Alan Jones told us what New Orleans-based group recorded the first song titled All I Want for Christmas Is You, and who recorded the second song with the same title? Vince Vance recorded the first song, and Mariah Carey recorded the second. We like the first one. Now, tonight's question. This early R&B classic includes toes the line, see my nanan and my paran in describing Christmas on the Bayou. Name the singer and the song. Email your answers to steppinout@wyes.org. Our prizes, we have a dish towel with the message, "Forget cookies, Santa loves beignets," from our friends at wearablevegetables.com, who, by the way, are donating a portion of every total purchase to Second Harvest to help fight hunger. And thanks to our friends at Pelican Publishing, we have a copy of the book, Christmas in New Orleans, by John McGill and me. And we have also a copy of the book, A Louisiana Christmas, Heritage Recipes and Hometown Celebrations, by Carol Stubbs and Nancy Rust. We also have a $50 gift certificate to Kitchen Witch Bookshop. And by the way, the Bayou Road Holiday Market will be held tomorrow starting at 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. Businesses in the 2500 block of Bayou Road will be hosting various vendors and food pop-ups with complimentary libations at several shops. Also, Junk Masters is there. That's a cool place. You can visit WYES.org for our online calendar to see our lineup of events, including downtown Covington's second Saturday Art Walk with the Roland Golden Gallery right there on North Columbia Street, and the presentation and signing of the Danny Barker autobiography, A Life in Jazz, with a discussion by Gwen Tompkins, who did the new foreword, and that is at Octavia Books. That's next Thursday evening. You can also link to our WYES YouTube channel to view our program. And now to Tony. So, Tony, how many months a year are you in Venice? How many in New Orleans, or does it vary?
No, it's mostly I used to be there all the time, then I was there half the time, then I was there 3 months out of the year, now I'm there like 90% of the time.
Wow. Well, you know, why not? Because a year ago, we had a good fortune to go and visit.
I thought you looked familiar. Yeah.
And you live in what is known as the Jewish Ghetto.
The Jewish Ghetto, yeah. I've been there about 12 years.
It's square.
Great. It's a great.
And it is very reminiscent of the Quarter.
Yeah, well, you know, you have all these old
apartment.
Buildings, of course, you know. And
you are in Venice.
It's, it's lovely, but no cars, no crime, no potholes. And the Venetian women have the best looking legs in all of Italy. So you got 500 bridges to negotiate every day. So we like that.
Now you have some brand new paintings.
Yes, ma'am.
You keep
I'm painting like a fiend. I'm painting like a fiend. And because I've got my life simplified now.
Look at
I have
that
a place
one.
Where I live.
Kubarkas.
Yay. Yes.
So you still paint New Orleans as well.
I'm always going to be from New Orleans no matter what. No matter what. Okay? Let everything else happen.
And
I'm
of
still
course, that's your Venice mode.
Yeah, that's the evening on Piazza San Marco and during the carnival.
Now, those campuses are usually pretty large, aren't they?
Those are big, yeah. One's the Renaissance of Humanity. Notice the Vatican's in the background. Anyway, so.
Wow. But you also paint scenes of Venice and New Orleans. You're still painting New Orleans, too.
Absolutely,
huh?
Yes. I have many projects going on.
Are these oils?
These are oils. Okay. So I work in oils on linen, and I'm now a freelance artist because I'm not affiliated with any gallery whatsoever.
Okay, so TonyGreen.net's even more important than ever before, right?
Yes.
Now you play gypsy jazz guitar,
ma'am.
And you're
going to
be playing around town, huh?
Yeah, we're playing next week a very wonderful concert at the St. Louis Cathedral with myself, James Singleton on bass, Tom McDermott on piano, Russell Welch, and Jerry Wayad Jumanville on saxophone.
Oh, wow. Oh, yeah, that's quite the lineup. Okay.
That's quite a lineup.
And you're at Dos Jefes,
yes.
And New Year's Eve.
At the Cafe Diga.
Now, that's a great setup, too.
Elegantly wild.
Yeah. So tell us about what you're going to be playing for us tonight.
Well, tonight I'm going to be playing, because I'm very interested in ethnic music from Europe, okay? I always have been. And part of my heritage, okay? And so I'm going to play an old gypsy folk tune called, it's not in their translations, basically, I axed a reindeer.
No, we should point out, we didn't say this, even though you live part of the time here in the Quarter, you're originally, though, from the West Bank, from Algiers, huh?
Yes.
Your family's been there a long time.
Yeah. So I'm a West Banker, but then I migrated to the French Quarter. So I'm always going to be from here, no matter what.
Well, I'm glad to hear. Well, we'll let you get ready.
Okay, thank you.
Tony has been playing gypsy jazz for many years and even participated in the Django Reinhardt, that wonderful gypsy jazz man himself, in France. Now, let's visit Tony and fellow guitarist Russell Welch performing on acoustic guitar, I Asked a Reindeer, an old Hungarian melody. Thank you. County Green and Gypsy Jazz will be performing next Wednesday, December 14th at St. Louis Cathedral and New Orleans in the Christmas New Orleans-style concert, which we certainly appreciate. Now it's time for our artist spotlight, yet another artist. This is Florida Schmorlida by New Orleans artist Annie Lustow. In addition to her art career, Lustow has long been a champion of the local music community. I love the title of that. An exhibit of her new works, Chromiscuity, happens with a reception that's tomorrow evening at the Ugly Dog Saloon and Barbecue on Andrew Higgins Drive on Annunciation Street in the Warehouse District. It will be on view through the new year. And we also have a photo, Luna Fed. You can do not miss that. From Lafayette Square, of course, it's Gallier Hall, illuminating Gallier Hall. It's the last night, tomorrow night, from 6 to 9 p.m. at the Art District Galleries. Will also be opening, having openings in conjunction with that incredible light show, the Arts Council. We have to thank for that. Wow, it just do not miss that. And I think that the shows are like 6, 7, 8, and 9. At the top of the hour, not to be missed. Alan,
and
he's
and
back.
You know, just as a little bit of an aside, they do the very same kind of thing in Jerusalem at the Tower of David, and you do not want to ever miss that show at night. It's fantastic.
And some of the illumination are actually images and icons, New Orleans-y things.
Right. Well, of course, there it's more about Jerusalem and the their history. But yes, this is fantastic. You've got all kinds of voodoo images and things of that sort that tell the story of New Orleans in pictures. So we wanted to talk a little bit about theater. You'll see there's an overarching theme of Christmas somewhat in the air.
Yes, there is.
But before I get into that, I wanted to mention that there are a couple of shows that are out there that are not Christmassy. So let's first off start with what could happen next. This is at the Ashe Cultural Center that's going to be coming up on the 10th and 11th of December. So, those of you who have seen Moses Damien in some of the works that he's done, he's a very interesting actor. He's really takes over a lot of the stage work. We've seen him in The Color Purple and several things that he's gotten a number of nominations for. Fantastic award-winning actor. And the Ashe Cultural Arts Center has this family comedy, if you will. Basically, it's a two-act play and puts you holiday spirit if you get a chance to get over there. Again, Chakula Chawa also is featured as an actor in it, and of course he directed this. So that'll be, again, $20, $15, depending on the cost there, but 3 p.m. on December the 11th, and I believe it's at 8 o'clock on Saturday. Now, coming up very soon, of course, Mark Cortali Productions presents Gavin Creel. Again, Mark and Jeffrey go back a long way as well, but this is the opportunity to see real top-rated actors and singers from Broadway, bring them here to New Orleans. This is going to be at Lupin Hall at NOCA. And Gavin Creel, those of you who don't know, he portrayed, I believe it was Elder Price in the Book of Mormon and stage in London, and just got off a fantastic run of She Loves Me, the musical that was brought back, and was also in the theaters, I think, this past weekend. So those of you who would love to see him perform up close and personal, that's going to be fantastic. Tickets run from $35 to $75, and I think it's fantastic because, first off, Mark keeps the cost low so people can go see that. And these are top-rated performers. You do not want to miss it. Also, coming up, Le Petit is going to get us into the holiday mood. Their welcome is all back. If you remember, last year we had that Panto show that they did, which is sort of like a throwback to some of the European comedies that would pop up around the time of holidays. And this is going to star Bob Eades Jr. Now, we don't have a production shot of him in this year's show, but he was Sleeping Beauty featured as Widow Chock-a-Block, so you can get an idea about the kind of irreverent comedies that they're going to do. And again, it's done, as I said, in European style. These are supposed to be the Musicians of Bremen, a holiday panto, and it's written and directed by John Green. He did Sleeping Beauty last year as well, and production's only going to run for 1 week, so keep that in mind. That's going to be the Musicians of Bremen, a holiday panto through December the 21st. Also, coming up, we have this farce called Mr. Puntilla and His Man, Matty. The show's directed and produced by the Titanic Productions founder, Elise Frosch. It's going to star Michael Martin. It also has a number of other people that you may recognize, Jekyll Hyde, Elijah Stone, Christine Rush. Basically, this is a major farce. And again, I don't know that much about it myself. I'm looking forward to seeing it and giving a report and a review on that as well. The Titanic Theater, though, is a new place that I've not seen any action going on as far as productions. 1340 Montague Street. That's 1340 Montague Street. And again, that will be running through December the 23rd. Also, there's a new musical that is being done called Jambalaya the Musical. This is by the creator Nancy Gregory. It's going to be drawing on some of her past that she has from living out along the bayou. It's set along the bayou. It's funny, irreverent, and again, I haven't yet seen it, but it is going to be running December the 21st to the 23rd only at the Orpheum Theater, so keep that in mind as well. Looks like this could be a lot of fun, and let's not forget, of course, the lovely Victory Bells at the World War II BB Stage Door Canteen. This is a show that they're bringing back, A Vintage Christmas, but it's going to run all the way until the day after Christmas, and I'll be able to see that and do a review on it for next week.
I understand pianist Tom Hook is doing the Burl Ives, so jolly old
course,
Saint Nicholas
is of
in
course.
Our future.
Yeah, he's great.
Thank you. All right, now time for our picks. Jeff.
Well, I have to say I'm going to Gavin Creel myself. Gavin, he's an amazing, amazing singer. He's going to be in Hello Dolly with Bette Midler coming up. So he's amazing.
Thank you. Poppy.
Well, once you're done kissing under the mistletoe at Tableau, head over to Cafe Adelaide in the Lowe's Theater and take photos with the new fabulous Christmas tree, all with cocktail ornaments. And you can, again, post on Instagram and win lots of prizes. Post holiday cheers at Lowe's.
Okay.
Hashtag.
Tony.
Okay. Oh, well, what's going on? What do you want to know? What?
Steel Poinsettias.
Steel Poinsettias. Oh, me. I'm at St. Louis Cathedral next week.
Yay. All right.
The LPO has a couple of things coming up. You know, they always do the Handel Messiah, but they're going to have an LPO Holiday Spectacular on the 10th coming up this Saturday, and Sunday the 11th is going to repeat at the Orpheum Theater. And again, I just love getting in the holiday mood with the LPO.
And
they're
Adam,
so good.
While you were gone this week, Tony Bennett, the week before Dolly Parton, Bright Lights, Big City, kiddo. It's very impressive, isn't it? And before we go to my picks, I wanted to show you these images from Cheryl Gerber's book, New Orleans, Life and Death in the Big Easy. This is Pretty in Pink, 2010, and then Pretty in Pink, 2013. I really recommend this book. That's the Pussy Footers. There you go. As a NOLA-themed Christmas present. I can't recommend it highly enough. And now my other picks, John Kemp. Our John Kemp will sign his book, Expressions of Place, speaking of a beautiful book, tomorrow from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. at Bay Books on Main Street in Bay St. Louis. Then tomorrow evening, he'll be at Lemieux Galleries on Julia Street to sign during the pre-Luna Fete from 5 to 7 p.m. Then on Sunday, John will be signing from 11 a.m. to noon at the Preservation Resource Center Holiday Home Tour, the headquarters at Trinity Episcopal Church. And that is going to be, of course, on Jackson. The tour, by the way, includes 8 homes in the Garden District, the PRC, Preservation Resource Center. We just showed you one of the homes, showing the sunroom in the home of Lynn and Scott Brown on First Street. Tickets are $45 and tours are Saturday and Sunday from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. Visit prcno.org for more information on that. Don't miss a Garden District Christmas concert on, and of course that is going to be at Our Lady of Good Counsel, and that's Sunday at 4 p.m. The Church of Our Lady of Good Counsel, as we said, on Louisiana Avenue. Admission is free. What a deal. And Marinie Pop's annual Christmas concert will be a little later, Sunday at 6 p.m. at the St. John Lutheran Church right there on Canal Street in Mid-City. Next Wednesday, the Gallier House presents How Christmas Came to New Orleans, a lecture by John McGill. And there'll be a wine reception at 5:30, and the presentation starts at 6 p.m. And I'll be signing books next Thursday, the 15th, early evening at Barnes & Noble on Vets. Thank you all so very much, and thank you for watching. Good night.
Global Star Satellite Communications, headquartered in Covington, Louisiana, connects the world. Global Star satellite voice and data products offer remote communications for lone workers and backup communications during emergencies and disasters. Global Star's products include Wi-Fi hotspots, tracking devices, and fixed and mobile phones. Be bold, be efficient, be heard. Global Star connects the world.